guys, and welcome back to my channel. As you know, I am the LD educator. I am a special education teacher, and my goal is to share hope and to dispel myths about special education and those with learning disabilities. So we've been doing a little series on the different types of common learning disabilities, and today we are talking dyscalculia. Yep, that's right. I know it's a tongue twister, but dyscalculia is a specific learning disability in the area of math. I also have a simulation tool that I want to share with you guys, and it is awesome. I will drop a link below so that you can go and check that out. Matter of fact, I encourage every special education teacher, every general education teacher, and even your parents to experience this, because we need to see and we need to be able to experience what our students experience on a daily basis sitting in our classroom. And when we are better able to understand what it feels like to actually have dyslexia, to have dyscalculia, or any other learning disability, we will develop a whole new level of empathy and being able to work with our students. So make sure you stick around. The simulation tool is something that I found online, and I simply think it is amazing. And so make sure you also share it with your peers. Okay, so before we get started, I would like to thank all of the teachers, parents, and individuals with learning disabilities who have been supporting my channel. If you're new here, then I invite you to subscribe. Also, click the bell button so you will not miss any of my upcoming videos. So dyscalculia is a lifelong condition that causes a child to have difficulty performing math-related tasks. It's not as well known or as understood as dyslexia, but some experts believe it occurs just as often. It goes by many different names. Some schools may refer to it as a mathematical learning disability. You may hear a doctor refer to it as a mathematics disorder. Still yet, some parents and some kids call it dyslexia math, which really doesn't make sense because dyslexia and dyscalculia are two different things. So stay away from that term because we don't want to confuse people. There's enough confusion out there already. So people who have dyscalculia generally have poor number sense and they struggle with working memory. Now, for the sake of this video, I decided to put the signs and symptoms in the description box below because I really want to jump ahead to the assimilation because I think it's such a cool tool. And I know for some of you, you think just going through those slides are boring. So for those of you who need to see that, please look down in the description box below and we're gonna jump right into the assimilation. Okay, so here we are. Just to kind of let you guys know, this is a website that I absolutely love. It is called www.understood.org. So hopefully you are very interested in doing this simulation for yourself, sharing it with general education teachers as well as your parents. I will make sure I put a link down below so that it will take you directly to it. So it's called Through Your Child's Eyes, and that's because they really want you to be able to experience this as if you were a child with a learning disability. Now, they actually have simulations for reading issues, writing issues, as well as attention issues, math issues, and organization issues. Now, I eventually might do a video for each one of these, but right now we're gonna go ahead on and focus only on the math. And we could either click on the math right here and go straight to it, or we can click here on experience it, and what they would want you to do is to, let's click on it. All right, here we go. It will allow you to personalize it. So if you teach in elementary, second grade, you can click on second grade. I think I am gonna do sixth grade, okay? And then it asks you what issues your child is having, or you know, what particular area. So for the sake of this video, we're gonna do the math issues. Now, let me just go ahead on and let you know, when I click on this, it's actually gonna give me a video of a child telling her story.
After that, then it's going to take us to the simulation. Now, if you do not want to hear the video, you can skip it, but I think it's also part of the experience, especially if you don't already have a particular student in mind. So let's go. All right, so it says math issues. Math issues go beyond doing addition and subtraction in the classroom. We'll show you how math troubles can add up for your child. All right, let's get started.
I'm Alex, and I'm in the sixth grade, and math is not easy for me. When I look at a math problem, all I see is confusion, and it's like, what are numbers? A lot of times I get the signs mixed up. I don't know what they're called. My brain is going here to there to there to there to there to there, and it's just so crazy that I just want to scream. My stomach starts to hurt. I start to think the worst things about me. It's so overwhelming and stressful that it's hard to even think.
And we're going to get started. It says exact change. Click on coins to play for goodies. When you have the exact change, hit buy. Ready? Start. All right, so this is an apple, 7 cents. I'm going to click on 5. Wait a minute. Oh, hold on. Let's see. Okay. Wait a minute. Okay, so up here. So 10 cents is 13 cents. 5 cents is, okay, so it's a quarter. Hold on. I missed a little key thingy. All right. Bye. No? Okay, there we go. All right, so 42 cents. 42 cents. Okay. So I guess we're going to do a nickel. So that's 34 plus, let's see, what does 7 give us? That's too much. Hold on. What happened? Okay, 13 cents. No, that's 40. So, okay, hold on. Let's go. I'm confused. Okay, 29 cents plus. Yay, that's it. This is so crazy. Oh, okay. Milk is 83 cents. All right, so I think I'm gonna start with this big number again, which gives me 34, the nickel. Then I'm gonna do the penny, 63 cents. Now I need something that says 10 cents, but it doesn't have 10 cents. So oh no. Do I want to try again? No, I don't. Let's continue. I don't want to do that one again.
So my guess is that activity was pretty frustrating for you.
And that's
just how children with math issues feel every time they're stuck on a math problem. But there's lots of different reasons why they might get stuck. One is that they might have difficulty retrieving math facts. So if a child doesn't remember that 5 times 4 is 20, they have to solve the problem every single time they see it. And that can be frustrating.
Yeah.
Another reason might be that they have difficulty remembering the steps and all the procedures they have to follow. Or maybe they remember them, but just have difficulty keeping track of where they're at and what they're doing. So I'd add on top of that, that the children might be feeling stressed out because they know they're not good at math, or they believe they're not good at math. And that stress adds to their difficulty and can make the problem solving even harder.
Absolutely.
So our job is to find what strategies fit what child. Does a child need practice learning math facts?
Let's go ahead on
this. Do they need support?
And so thank you for experiencing through your child's eyes.
So wasn't that really cool? Now, if you could have really seen my face, you would have seen me like, oh, what is this? So it was a bit confusing. And as you could see, I still never got the answer to the third question. So once again, I encourage you to do this simulation yourself and then pass it on to your colleagues as well as your friends or vice versa. So if you're a parent, pass it on to teachers. Teachers, if you are a teacher, pass it on to your parents. And if you are an individual with a learning disability, you don't have to take it because you experience it every day. well, that's it. Stay tuned for my next video coming up. I'm not exactly sure which learning disability I will be talking about, but I encourage you to stick with me. If you guys have any questions or anything that you eventually would like for me to do a video on, please get in contact with me. I have an IG account, and that is at the LD Educator. And as always, you can also communicate with me down below in the comments section. Have a great one. I am.